I'm researching robotics and specifically how we can use deep learning to build end-to-end robotic systems directly from raw perception data. We're trying to actually learn these controllers so that they don't have any understanding of the world beforehand. They don't understand what a lane marker is, what a road boundary is, but they can learn all of this just by interacting with the environment in this virtual simulation engine that we've built. Most autonomous car companies are going to take a pipelined approach. So the first thing they're going to try and do is split up the problem into many sub-problems. One of those sub-problems could first be taking all of your sensory data and fusing it together. Once you have a representation of all of that data, you need to detect objects in the world, understand where all of those objects are, what are the objects, maybe if they're moving, if they're static. Then once you have a representation of where everything is around you, you need to understand where you are with respect to everything else. Then you can start to plan your path around that world. What we're doing here is radically different. We're not going to split up this problem at all. The entire problem is end-to-end solvable from pixels, from the sensory information, to the steering wheel angle. And what that means is that we try and learn a single machine learning system in the middle that transforms those sensory inputs to the control outputs that we want the car to predict without any pipelining at all. Our simulation is made up of hundreds of hours of driving data. We train this vehicle in all of these driving conditions and in many different scenarios in each of those conditions. What makes our simulation engine so unique is that it's data driven, so it's built off of real data of the road, which means that the more data we have, the more rich our simulation engine is, and the stronger our vehicles will be when we try to transfer them into the real world. We try and make incremental progress and incremental steps towards that full deployment stage. We train on all of these 100 hours of data. It takes our autonomous vehicle in simulation maybe 10 hours to go through all of this data beforehand, and then it learns that controller and then can apply it onto the real road within maybe 10 hours of training. I think it's a really interesting research question of how we can build autonomous vehicles that take as input some prior information about the world, specifically because humans have so much of that prior information already built up from many years and years of driving. But it's a very interesting research question to think about also how we can learn these control systems from scratch without any knowledge. It's a huge challenge, and it's one that we don't really have a great answer to right now. Because driving is such a complicated task, even though we know that lane markers are incredibly important, we don't really know the underlying rules and foundational control systems that govern a self-driving car yet. And that's what we're trying to learn from scratch.